Hi everyone, it's Sean at Vixen Digital here. We help you to get the right clicks. So today I've got a really quick video for you. I'm going to show you how to add some ad variations in your account to help you do some split testing. So stay tuned, all of this coming right up. Okay, let's get started. So I'm going to start off by opening up Google Chrome. This is the browser I'm going to be using today, and I've got myself a little AdWords bookmark in the bookmarks bar, which might be something useful you can add to your bookmarks bar just to help you navigate to AdWords a little bit easier. So once I'm in AdWords, I am going to be using the same account that I created in a previous video. And as you can see, we can ignore this today. This is just a little warning at the top asking me to add my billing information, which I haven't done yet. So this is something that you can do by going to the little spanner and go to billing and payments. Okay, so on with the video and on with the ads. So I'm going to be adding some ad variations to this ad group here. So pizza takeaway. Okay, so if I just go to my ad groups very, very quickly, you can see that I've got pizza takeaway. Okay, these are my two ad groups. And as we showed in the last video, these actually have one keyword per ad group. So I'm going to go over to Ads and Extensions, and in Ads and Extensions, if you've just got all of them selected, you'll see all of the ads that you've got available to you. But if I go and select the ad group that I want to work on, and then we'll see that I've only got one ad currently running. So the best practice and what Google advises us to do is actually run a variation of ads. So we can run a variation of ads and perform a split test or A/B testing. This means that we can test different messages and different messaging within our ads in order to be able to further optimize the performance of our ads and to try and improve our ads performance and improve click-through rate and other aspects of the account. So if I go to If I want to add an extra ad, as we can see here, then I go to this little plus symbol and I'm going to add another text ad. Now, we've already got all of this automatically filled in for us from our previous ad. So the best way to perform split testing is to change one element of your ad. So that's how we can conduct a very accurate and reliable test. Because if we were to change everything, and we just had a totally different ad, then we wouldn't be able to pinpoint the exact specific element that actually changes or has an impact on the ad's performance or has an impact on the click-through rate, for example. So in this circumstance, I'm just going to change the headline too. So let's put a different variation of the headline too in. So let's say homemade pizza London. So now we've got homemade pizza London, and I'm going to leave everything else exactly the same, and I'm going to save this new ad. So now we can see that we've got two ads that are running. One of them is best pizza in London and one of them is homemade pizza London. So what we are going to test here is the headline too. So if this ad, after we've gathered enough data, if this ad is performing better by looking at our metrics, then we can get rid of this ad and we can perform another test. However, what Google wants us to do, and the best practice for Google, is that we have to add another ad, so another variation. Google particularly likes it when you've got three separate ad variations running at the same time. So I'm going to conduct another test on the headline too, and this one can be free delivery. Free delivery London. Okay, I'm going to save this new ad. So now we should have, yes, we have three different ads with three different headline twos. So after conducting a split test and gathering as much data, so as gathering as many impressions as possible, we can then start to see which of these ads is going to perform the best. Okay, so once we have enough data, and we've conducted a split test, we can then decide to either conduct the same split test again on with different variations of the headline too, or we can go on to another aspect of the ad. So in the future, we could then, for instance, if just for this particular example, I'm just going to go back to my ad groups. I'm just going to go to the other ad group I've got with the broad match modifier, and I'm going to click on the ads. So in the future, we could conduct a different split test by actually changing the description to see which description works best. So over time, we can start to optimize and perfect our ads to get the best results possible. Okay, so thanks for listening today and thanks for dropping by. Stay tuned for more videos, and I hope this helps.